Workflow tweak 1. If you want to replace a piece of a MIDI part and you drag the new piece on top of it, it overlaps and plays both. Unless you go to Settings, Editing, Delete Overlaps. Tweak 2. So you've automated the send level of a track, and later on in the mixing process, you want to increase or decrease the overall send level, but you want to keep the automation curve. In that case, go to Project, Automation Panel, click Trim, and make sure it's all in write mode. And then you can offset the entire automation lane, or just parts of it. Tweak 3. If you need a whole section to disappear without changing anything that comes after, you can do ripple editing. Hold Shift Option or Alt to select, and Shift Delete to completely remove it. If you want to keep that part to paste it somewhere else, then instead of delete time, choose cut time. And then 4 more things that come in very handy for plugins. When you want to add an extra plugin somewhere in the middle of your chain, instead of adding it at the bottom and then moving it, go to the right zone, VST effects, and find your plugin, and then just drop it on the insert slot where you want it to be. Next, let's say I have a bunch of plugin windows opened. If you assign a key command to select next plugin window, you can switch between plugins like this. And if you add one to close all plugin windows, you guessed it, they all close. And a key command that's already assigned by default is Option or Alt A, which is Activate or Deactivate Focused Object. And that simply means toggling the plugin's bypass.
So I hope that helped. If it did, please like the video, subscribe, and have fun making music.